In days long ago, when the spirit of the nation filled our borders from the sky to the sea, lived a man named O'Neill with the eye of an eagle and the voice like the wind in the trees. Though schooled by the Gaul in faraway England, this noble son they thought their pawn would be. But English wealth and titles for the Earl of Dungannon could not bribe his Irish dignity. As time marched on, the strength of this chieftain came to challenge the rule of the Pale. As one by one, the people came to recognize O'Neill as the savior of the Gael. And O'Donnell led the band of the greatest clans of Ulster to follow this one man's destiny. And they gathered like storm clouds over the ocean, and they burst with the will to be free. Like flames through the west swept the armies of Ulster as invader fell before O'Donnell's sword. With O'Neill from the north, they met at Blackwater in a place that's known as Yellow Ford. And arrayed against the Gaels were the finest troops from Europe, brass cannon, musket plume, and Tudor gold. But gallows, glass, and kern cut them down with Celtic fury for the victory that the prophet had foretold. Now Ireland's is a history of temporary victories, and so it was for Hugh in his day. Spanish aid across the water drew the Irish to their slaughter at Kinsale on a morning dark and grey. But to those who would say that such struggle was folly, that Irish ways and laws weren't meant to be, remember that one man backed his dreams up with action, and for 9 bloody years kept Ireland free. And for 9 bloody years kept Ireland free.